seeing it because I'm not seeing anything. Yeah, Aaron, it's not showing on the other side here.
Yeah.
I can see that it says we are live, but.
Yes, you can go now.
I can go where?
You can, yeah, we are live, yeah.
Are we, is it only now that we are live?
Yeah, it's showing now, it's we are live, yeah.
Oh, I see it. Let me try and go to it. Okay. But now.
Yeah, this, yeah, we are live.
Okay. Can you please share it on your page as well so that people can see? All right. Hi guys, please come in. We are just sorting out a few things. We are here. I can see people are coming in now. Thank you. Come. Right. Thank you guys for sharing. Please share. We are streaming live. Tell everyone we're streaming live from our page. I need to. Okay. Looks like I'm good for today. All right. Okay. Please come in. I can see you. We see you. Please come in. We see you guys. Just trying to work on our screens here today. Trying to make sure that people can see us clearly. All right. Guys, come in. Thank you so much for tuning in. Yes, I've shared it. Okay. Guys, can you see me? Can you hear me? Please signal if you can hear me. I can see some of you are coming in. Thank you. let's just make sure that we hear each other so that by the time I start, we don't stop. I just want to check on my feed if it's there. Okay, it's not there on my feed. Let me try share it again. It's not there on my feed. Oh, it's sharing on a different page. Let me do that again. Now I see what was the problem. All right, I need to change that. Uh-oh. It's showing. Yes, we are here. All right. Something went wrong with working on this. Okay. I think I'm still unable to share on my feed. I'll keep trying it as we go. Okay, I'm unable to share from my page. I don't know why. Can please someone tag me so that we. All right. Hello, everybody. Thank you for tuning in. We are here today. Label, are you here? Label, are you here? Aaron, are you here? Joseph, are you here?
I'm here, sir.
Okay, so your network today is good.
Yep.
All right. Where's Joseph? Joseph, are you there?
I think Joseph is still sorting out something.
Oh, okay. All right. He should be here. Guys, I see your comments. I see everyone. Thank you so much to those who've joined us today and those who are coming in for the first time. Thank you for coming through. Thank you for coming through. Please tag as many people as you can. I see everyone do. I see you, Tietze. I see Colin, Zikali, Harrison, Ganyiso, Pumlani, Lebu. I see everyone. JC, I see you. Andres, Prisco. I see a lot of people here. Please tag everyone. We are here. Thank you so much. Apologies for being late. Actually, we were early. It's just that we were struggling to log in. Obviously, you can't prove that, but we are here. We are so excited. I see everyone has joined in. Josie, I can see your face now. Does that mean you are back? I'm considerably back. Okay, give us more volume.
I'm trying to be fully back.
Okay.
Yeah, but so it's just that there were changing circumstances. As you can see, I'm not where I was.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So was Stella today. We are spinning a tradition food. Are we fooling us? We're not original. I won. Oh. She took corners or shot, I guess. So I'm not so bad.
Well, Stevens got you over, my brother. So.
Yeah.
Yeah. No. So I'm trying to get settled, but it's not. Bear with me.
Okay. All right. We're good. I know that Nebu is still trying to sort out his situation. And as we all know, that he's we're sort of like used to him now being in and out. Guys, we see your comments. Thank you so much for all those who are here. We are starting. So today's show is definitely going to be long. And and let me just apologize in advance to those who are always saying something about their data that is getting finished and all of that. We truly apologize. It's just that the show is long. If you remember very well, the first day when we started the producer's talk, when we started during the first week or the first few days of lockdown, I did mention that the producer's talk really, it's not a TV show, is more of a chillus. This is where we get to invite our friends and people that we respect to come in and join us, and we are very free. So sometimes you might find that maybe I'll take long to explain something. Please don't get irritated by that, or maybe our guest or whoever that is talking, or Label Joseph, they're taking long in explaining something. It's not really an interview show. We are just free. We are flowing. If we have a guest, we are actually visiting them in their house. We are chilling with them. So, we are just going with the flow. So please don't expect a certain way maybe of questioning and follow up and trying to get a lot in a short space of time and whatnot. We are just chilling. And if we don't finish, we don't finish. We'll come back next week. Please bear with us. I know that I've been getting a lot of messages and people are happy with the show. And obviously there's always suggestions. someone is saying that my voice is a bit low. I've pushed it really loud now. So please bear with us. We know that, I know that some, Nico is saying you deserve to have a TV slot. Yes, we do. It's just that now we will have to restructure the show so that it's more of a, it's more TV style kind of production. So here we are just chilling and just talking, and we might take forever. We might push until 12 o'clock tonight, or we might push until 10:30. We are just relaxed. We don't have pressure. We are not worried about airtime or TV time. So Yeah, so today we blessed the Lord about last week, Wednesday. I know some of you really sent amazing messages in boxes. Just thinking about last week for last week's show. And I think it was amazing. It was really, 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 really amazing. We were really blessed and fortunate enough, by popular demand, we had to do part two, which part two is today. And I had to call in the two gentlemen and to request them to join us again tonight. And we felt like there was a lot of things that were still left hanging. And we just want to tighten up. Today is going to be the last day, definitely. It's part two, and it's the finale of the part two, finale of the part one, or celebrating Pastor Mthunzi Namba. And Babu Mbata is here. Mbata, are you there? Can you hear me? He's here. He's joining us today. Okay, cool. He's here. And Mfundisi Namba is here as well. So let me just have them come through. I need to see them on grid view. So guys, can you hear me? Can I hear you say something? Mfundisi, are you there?
I'm here. God is good. Amen.
Mbata, are you there?
It's good to be here again.
Yes, no matter how much weed. No matter how much weed, we see you.
Stop reading.
Yeah, so I'm sure Asaz the pale up later on the party. There's like no matter how much weed. So we're not sure.
It's okay.
please sell it. No matter how much weed, please sell it to me.
Okay.
All right, the guys are here. Josie is here. Lebza is here. Mfundisi, maybe just to recap before we start our part, you touched on amazing things last week. Maybe we can just recap quickly. I mean, last week's video is already on 7,000 views. We've never had that. Thank you so much. Numbers don't lie. So abantu bakhumbulile wangempela nje wangakubona abanye kwezinye izindawo bakubona nje mase kuyishow ye joyous naku stream sebandla. So we truly appreciate you. Thank you so much for everything that you've released last week. We thank the Lord. Some of the things we spoke about, just want us to touch quickly and just recap to those who are not there, or maybe they might not have seen the video. We touched on balancing skill, talent with the spiritual side of things. And what is music production according to you? And balancing family and music. So we'll just recap quickly and then we will start maybe with some of the surprises that we have for today. Balancing skill with the spiritual side of things. How important, where would you want to start? Awkward corner, eh?
It is awkward because now if you want to take me back, those who did not see it last week must go back and follow up, make a follow up, because to recap, you know, it is important to balance the two.
Yeah.
Like I said last time, I believe that it is God who gives us the empowerment. It is Him who God wants and expects skill as well. But we cannot now take that from a heart that is not ready to serve Him, because then it becomes like any other performance. That's what makes it different when someone is playing with an anointing than when someone is playing with only skill and the knowledge. And it would be just like any other performance. There won't be any difference.
Yeah.
So both are important.
Both are important.
Both are important. Both are important. And both are needed. But when everything is said and done, what sets you apart. It's not only the skill can set you apart from the worldly perspective, and where people will applaud what you're doing. And what that will do, it has a tendency of growing a beast inside of you, where now the pride, you get more proud, you get more pompous, then you begin to get into a spirit of competition. Whereas when you balance both, then you always remain humble, because you understand it's not about you. It becomes very clear that it's not about you. Then you begin to understand yourself as a servant that is ready to be used by God. Yeah.
Singa kushubisa kakhulu sisesaqaleni.
But I know. That's why I said you lead it. But I was just saying it is important to balance both. Mm. Remember that you said singa kushubisa. Remember that skill without spirituality will have to be sustained by other things. That is where substance abuse comes in. Because you have this skill, and you know this skill cannot carry you. It can open doors for you from the worldly perspective, but for it, you need to sustain it. That is why people then will get into using weed, they get into drugs, they get into different things, so that, maybe let me not rush it, because this is going to lead us into something else. So that's why, with the skill and at the same time the issue of spirituality, then we need to define what that is as well.
Okay, let me I know that the guys are still getting themselves ready. I want to ask you a question that had risen kakhulu lesasikhathi see when we're doing season one,
right?
Around that issue, you as a man of God and as an artist of the day, you find yourself that the people that you've booked for the recording or for the show, some of them are really talented, but they have a situation of using substances like alcohol and weed or whatever. So how did you, have you ever found yourself in a situation like that? I mean, from the choir as well, or maybe from...
Many times.
And how do you deal with that? Or what is the right way? Or what would be the right way to deal with it? Because now you need this person, he's very talented, but kunaleyo situation yokuthi unesimo sokuphuza umfowethu or indenjalo nje.
You see, then that's a very difficult situation, because it will address the issue of before the concert or the gig, as you will, during the time of preparation, how much was done with the group of people you're working with. If it was just a rehearsal where you learn songs, you learn the material and prepare for the gig, then when the day of the gig comes, nothing was deposited even during the preparation. So when it's time now for the gig, a person just rocks up, he's drunk or whatever, you are facing a situation where nothing, there were no clear guidelines and rules right from the beginning. Now, because now it's going to take you to now asking yourself a question: when you prepare for the gig, who do you book? You begin to address those issues. I like some so-and-so. He's very good as a player, but he's dry. He has no oil. Brilliant musician, no oil.
Yeah.
You see now, then you decide just before the rehearsals begin, who am I going to book? It becomes a problem, because as you said, finally, the guy is highly talented. But when you know as an individual, as Coley, that during my gig, I believe the Lord wants to achieve this through me.
Mm.
It's just that the scenarios are not the same. You can be invited to go and do a gig in a place where you just expected to do five songs. It's in and out, and there's no ministry. It's a job. That is a different setup, because there you're just going to perform.
Mm.
Yeah.
I think just before Nimigu Bambata, I follow up. I think I want to ask him as well the similar question, because I can tell you number of times when we book people, sometimes we find that we don't know that side of them.
Right.
Abafoi to ban a challenge it is. But sugega kulus kijimisi skill number one. Or two, you know, there's a last minute gig that is happening and you're just looking for a musician that can come in and fill in.
Right.
Just to make the gig and whatnot. So, but what are your thoughts around there? Because I mean, I know that we've dealt with a lot of people in that space, and sometimes they are there in the church. Umuzo nje umuntu akhona la ebendini ukuthi kune spirit esinukayo nje sincane nje say sentry ayizolo. So but manje nangu talented nangu ijuba liyehla la uya worship ijuba nali liyehla liyavukuza but uninkinga nje ye spinza yabona.
Yeah.
Asazi
phela and why you guys Why are you guys talking about this after the announcement I don't know if it has to do with that, but okay.
Yeah, level three.
Fundis.
level
three fundis.
Hey.
But it might not necessarily be my personal experience, struggle with alcohol or drugs or anything. It's just character issues sometimes. You find that this brother or this sister, it doesn't have an alcohol problem, drugs problem. It's just character issues, man, when you have to deal with other things other than focusing on what you came to a rehearsal for. Yes. You know, that when you bring... It's sometimes it gets to a point where it's even costing financially, because we work with time, and this time is paid for, you know, at a rehearsal, and just as much as it is a gig, someone has to be paid for this, you know. Sometimes we find ourselves in a situation where we feel like people don't respect what we do, which might be caused by the fact that they've encountered us in our rehearsals or in our gigs, and they've realized that we're just playing, you know, we're not taking what you do seriously. And that is based because of the character issues, you know. We were not raised the same way from where we come from, you know, and to some, it might be work. To some, it might look like a hobby. Some say it's work, but they treat it as a hobby. So it's an issue. And thank God that I'm able to choose my own musicians, you know.
That's it.
Yeah,
sometimes you find yourself as a producer where you have to do a project where you are given personnel.
Yeah, I wanted to jump right in there because
jump in.
Because that question ibi khona ivelile kaningi on season one where the question is. Is Mbata as a producer choosing his band, or the artist, is he choosing the band? How do you guys compromise? How do you meet each other? What are your rules when as Mbata? So before Ngiyaku Mfundisi, what has
Mbata chooses his own band?
Yeah,
I learned from the best. You choose your own people, bruh. It's one of my very strong conditions.
Yeah.
If you want to work with me, I want to work with my team, because you might have seen my work before and you want me to achieve what you've seen before. You know, for me to be able to give you that product, I have to come with the team, you know.
Right.
I prefer bringing my own team, but I won't lie, sometimes there is a discussion between myself and an artist where he says, hey bro, I just want to bring this. Sometimes I'd ask why. Some of the reasons they would say, man, I just want them to be around you just to grow and learn. This is my personal keyboard player or my personal guitar player. And if I see a space, I allow them to come in. But I would say, Cole, it always comes with a specific some costs in it.
Yes.
You know,
oh, no,
some
no,
compromise
does.
In it, even
yeah.
the production.
Some compromise, yeah.
You know, having,
yeah.
having to re-record some of the parts that
yeah.
didn't come out at the recording. But it's a decision that I personally make, you know. But
yeah.
to everyone out there who would want to have a producer, I would say just give them freedom to do what they need to do so that you'll mm-hmm. be happy, because you chose them knowing how they work.
Yeah.
No. What Ngubeka is talking about is so true, that it's important for you as a producer to choose the musicians or the people to work with, because you know that they understand you and you know how they're going to interpret the
yeah.
song that you're giving them or
yeah.
the songs that they're supposed to do. So you don't just pull any person. And he spoke about the issue of personality, the character. I mean, you bring someone who's a diva, you know, with a brilliant
yeah.
voice, but the way they are, they don't respect themselves and they're not respecting what they're doing. Then it affects everyone. You know, there are those kinds of people you book for a gig or for a session. It's when they come, everyone just says, hey, you know, they for some reason, they are carrying a spirit that will dilute what is supposed to be done.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Hey, yeah, in the way, character is
yeah.
very annoying. I mean, I think every guest that we had has kapunat on that one, Guti. In the way, character is tricky, man. It's tricky, it's a problem. Josie, are you there?
I am.
I thought you were raising your hand, but I wasn't sure what's happening there.
No, I wasn't raising my hand. I was just
okay.
organizing.
Okay. Mfundisi, we've got a long show. I would want us to I'm not sure if I'm ready or everyone is ready. We wanted to start somewhere today, and then Sizo Valangayo will end with the talk. And then just start on some tributes that we have. And I think after people saw our show, some of the close friends that we speak to on daily basis, they saw the show last week, and some of them were saying how nasivalela ngaphandle bafethu sikhona. And
right.
you know, some people really wanted to say something to you. And I mean, the whole point, yeah, your invite even from last week was just to celebrate you and say thank you over and over until you are tired of hearing thank you. So I wanna share my screen because we're using Zoom, so we're unable to do some of the productions that we were doing before when we do the musical shows and whatnot. So let me just, for disclaimer, this video is quite long and it has different people that I couldn't play last week. They just want to share their experience
okay.
with you. And then I think when we are done with all of that, and then we'll come back, I want us to jump into some few questions that we have and then go in there. Are we all good, guys? Can I go to the tributes now? We good, no?
Sure.
Yeah.
Okay. Let me share my screen. How do I do that again? Share right there. Okay, let me look for. All right. Just a second, guys. All right. So the challenges from Pizzu's. I know that some of them they sent late, so we couldn't prepare them, but there's too many of them, and others we had to cut them down because of the quality, maybe. But we have a lot. Okay. Okay, sorry, it's playing on my side. I didn't share. Let me just jump in there. Okay. Right, there we go.
Savior Jesus Christ, to all the viewers of Producers Talk. My name is Bishop Stephen Mulaking. I'm here to talk about the legend himself, man. The year was 1991. I got to meet the apostle, the prophet, Mthunzi Namba. And I think I should believe I'm one of his firstborn sons. We met him when we were doing what called Sweetwater Manzimdoti, that branched into Family Factory, that branched into Joya Celebration. So I met him there when after we've just done Sweetwater Manzimdoti and we were part of the project. What can I say about the legend? If one thing I would really truly love for the singers of now, I wish they could have met the man of God to work with him. The man just brings inspiration and on many levels. You'll be shocked at the things that he would do. But one of the things that I would tell you that are probably funny about him is that we could meet for rehearsals in the morning. When we're supposed to rehearse, waiting to learn a song, he'll say, "Asamitosa," and you know, with those eyes. And then we'll all probably drive to Wamaimai somewhere to eat. And he always knew the corners of Joburg where you can find food. In shady corners, but you could find good food. So we'll drive probably to places like Wamaimai. He loved Wamaimai. So we could just sit and eat upapu and inkliziyo. And spend probably 2 hours eating. And probably spend 1 hour rehearsing. And it didn't make sense. However, one of the things that I quickly learned about that process was that there's so many things that you would not necessarily learn in a rehearsal room, but you learn in fellowship. Because if you can get together and be in harmony and eat to break bread together, there's so many things that you can conquer. The men will just call you for food anytime. By the time you get there, it's a school of people sitting just to have food. And one of the also the memories I remember about him is when we were doing Joy Celebration. I remember we were in East London one time. They just called, because I was probably in charge of a lot of group of singers then. They called me, told me they had an accident. Him, Lindelani, and Jack Loman. We were all worried. Then we started praying in tongues. They came back. I don't know where they found bandages and everything. They came back looking like crap. And we were all crying only to find that they were just pulling a leg. There's so many things that we could say to the man of God about him. But one thing that I would like to say, I would just want to say to him, thank you. Thank you for birthing me. And funny enough, many guys that you birth are in ministry. They're doing ministry. They're doing music as well. But thank you for just being you. Words can't really truly express how much I love you. You're a blessing.
Hi guys, my name is Brenda Mdambo, and when I was asked to say something about Babu Mthunzi Namba, I was giggling, I was laughing, because I was thinking of all the great moments that we had in Joy Celebration under his leadership. He's someone who taught us a lot of things in terms of music. I don't know, there's a gift that he has that makes you guys just sound amazing. I don't know, we used to say, when he's present, when he's there, everything changes. I think it's just a gift that he has. There's a lot of other moments that I can talk about. But for me personally, in my own growth, I would like to thank you, Babu Namba, for helping me understand my voice and helping me being able to execute my voice better. I'll never forget what you taught me in terms of that. I'm sure you can still remember what you taught me. You told me about the ability to brighten my voice and the ability to strengthen my falsetto. And you taught that like I could understand what you meant. You know, you made it so easy, and that helped my tone drastically, and it helped me kakhulu. That just indicated the kind of a teacher that you are, and the kind of a producer that you are, and the kind of a leader that you are. You have this gift of helping someone be better and do better. I remember there's one thing that I'll never forget that you said. You said, when people are still clapping for you, you must know that you haven't really done well. People must know that you are good, and it shouldn't shock them when you are good. So when they always say, "Oh my God, that was great," you know, you used to say, that shouldn't be something that you, today, also good, you know, because most are so good in Bella, they'll just know that you are good. They'll never expect anything less. That's what you said. I'm not sure if you still remember that. And I would like to thank you for grooming me, grooming a lot of us in our era, in your celebration and featuring us in your project, that you know, taught me a lot of things. Working with you closely has really, really taught me a lot. And for that, I would like to thank you and to honor you, you know, to honor you and say you are a great musician and a great leader. And your legacy is something that need to be celebrated while you're still alive. For that, I would like to say thank you so very much.
Hello, everyone. My name is Sabata Masoga. I'm one of the musicians, vocalists that have been privileged enough to work with Bishop, Apostle, Pastor Mthunzi Namba. I had an amazing time working with him as a producer, as an arranger. He's one person that when you work with, understands. Once he wants to understand your voice, your vocal capabilities. He used to tell me that I need to also use my lower registers, not always on my higher registers. My lower registers are actually much beautiful than my higher registers. So I used to learn about placing, about blending as a backing singer again with other voices, and how to handle a song. You don't just start a song up there. By the time you finish, people will be tired of you. So I've learned so much from this man of God, and thank you so much, Tatum Twenzi, for that. I'm still carrying it, and you've taught me how to be humble if I want to learn. So hence I was able to work with each and every other different genre artist, because I would just listen as a child and learn. I am still learning. Thank you so, so much. God bless you, man of God.
Hi, this message is to Dada Mthunzi Namba. This is just a message of gratitude, the great producer, vocal arranger, composer, musical director, band leader, well, you used to call it back in the day. I'd just like to thank you personally for growing my musicality, where, you know, you introduced what it is to be a band to me and what a band should sound like. I really appreciated how you brought together the sound of a band. I remember my first encounter seeing your work live was Restoration Hour, I think, recorded live at Grace Bible Church back in the years, some years ago, probably over a decade ago. I was still young then, I'd already started playing, but just to watch you work with the musicians and how you commanded the stage and how you directed the stage, and even in your performance, how you still kept everyone together in it, and just how everything was arranged and put together, and your geniusness, if there's such a word. I just like to say thank you. And we appreciate you for the work you've done over the past years, for what you've done for shaping South African gospel music as a whole. I think we all owe it to you, producers alike, co-producers alike, musical directors alike, and you've shaped a serious sound that is unshakable, and no one can take that away from you. Sir, you are great. Co-founder of Joyous Celebration. Joyous has gone on to be an award-winning gospel group, the biggest African gospel group, actually. And we know that you've done a lot of work also in building that. So I'd just like to thank you on a personal capacity as well. I know I'm currently working on your new album coming out soon. I'm co-producing on that, and it's been quite an exciting journey working with you. I've realized you're quite particular on a few things, but we're getting there slowly but surely. I'm excited about that. So as people wait for that as well, we wait in anticipation, and I just like to say thank you, and we honor you, sir. Have an awesome lockdown period, and stay safe.
Sanbonani Kamlam Ngosifiso Khangile, and my journey with Mthunzi is a very interesting journey, a journey of encouragement, a journey of inspiration, a journey of teaching, a master and a student. I am really privileged to have worked with Ubaba Namba, and I don't think umangibuka ijourney yami as a musician, ijourney yami as a person, ijourney yami just through life, ukuthi how would it have been if I ngihlangane no Ubaba Namba. Ubaba Namba changed me, Ubaba Namba influenced me and inspired me in so many ways. You know, I am who I am today because of a contribution ayenzile. You know, it was a beautiful journey. Kwangimnandi kona sometimes masisebenza because hey, we were grilled, you know, very hard. But today most of my musicians and my producers, our audiences are enjoying the fruits of your intelligence. They're enjoying the fruits of your investment. You know, God is kuluma recently with Steven Nabo Margaret, and umasise studio sebenza, we do not struggle. Izinto owasifundisa zona, they just flow naturally out of us, you know. And a little story, ukuthi uma sisebenza, mhlambe mina nabontokozo labo sibu, we would look forward to getting ama envelopes because ama envelopes would be accompanied by izinto ezi two as interesting. One was what we called a love letter, which would be a letter of encouragement in a verse, mhlambe bese iba nama areas of improvement, ukuthi improve here, improve there. And that was a true mentorship program. And into esibili in those envelopes was imali. Ukuthi sasazi ukuthi mhlambe, for an example, standard fee is 1.5, but mhlambe eyomuya izoba R1,599.96, emuya izoba R1,550.32. You know, that would be interesting. But we really had to earn our stripes with Ubaba Namba, and we learned ukuthi and izinto they don't just come easy. You have to work hard ukuze ube recognized, ukuze ube ranked a certain way. But Ubaba Namba, I really thank God for you. Thank God for your life. May you be blessed and know ukuthi you are highly, highly appreciated and you are loved. Thank you very much.
Your mic is off.
Mfundisi.
I the last speaker.
In fact, what Fiso spoke about, I remember that my first envelope as well. I think it was after our first gig well in Cape Town. I remember, I think we're going to 1.8 50 and 55 cents. What was the concept really?
Lalela Koli, Lalela Koli. Hey,
love letter in Zima.
He is the only one who has given us love letters. Yeah, well, and they were very personalized. They were not the same. You had your own love letter that spoke to you. And one of the things that I learned from Lama 50 Red and when we challenged their Tumfundis would say, your contributions are not equal. And I took that. I said,
oh, you took that.
I took that. People don't contribute equally for the two, right?
Aslingani, what do you have to say, Aslingani?
Sorry, oh
just,
my God!
Just out of curiosity, so are we? Were you guys? Your contribution is different by 50 rands and stuff.
Or, have, like, Joseph, stop it, Baba! You will never understand this, Baba. Stop.
I just like the idea that Ngubeko says, "I took it."
You saw some of the messages that came through.
Amazing, very, very, very humbling. You know, and I'm very, very grateful to the Lord. I mean, what Fiso was talking about, I had completely forgotten about it, to be honest with you.
Mm-hmm. And I think even then, when one was doing that, it carried different messages. But it for me, they were like abantwana bami kind of, and students. You know when you believe in people that you're working with, and you can see they can become the best that they can be. So you'll do anything to try and motivate and invest in them so that you can sit back and enjoy seeing them fly.
Mm. Yeah. I want to confirm something with you. And I think in response, yes or no, if iyafitha kuleyo ku yes or no, or ku true or false.
Right.
When you did a gig a while back with, I think it was with Vuyo, his band specifically requested Chappies from you because they saw you taking out, I think it was Chappies or Sweets, something like that.
Right.
And they requested to have. And when you gave them into Klinisiso, please confirm, true or false? I'll explain for this.
You put him in a tight spot and explain. I'll tell you why. Because I remember that very well. We were in Nels Page, if I'm not mistaken.
Yes.
On tour, we had something called with Vuyo and Jabu, which was called Healing the Nation or something like that.
Yeah.
But there is this guy, the bassist.
Yes.
Lundi.
Lundi and Lucha, yes. It was Lundi, yeah?
Yes, the bassist. I gave him something just to encourage him. He drank. No. It was not sweet. They saw me drinking with Jabu. They saw us drinking, I think, some multivitamins or something like that.
Yeah.
So they said, "Ish, what is that for?" We said, "No, it's just for energy and just, you know, just to boost, you know, give you strength." He said, "Hey, can I have one?" Then I swapped it and I gave him something else. And he drank that during the performance. As the song is going and Vuyo is busy singing there, suddenly the bassist felt some rumbling in his tummy. And I'm sitting at the back on backstage and I'm just watching him. The way he dropped the bass.
Yeah.
and he rushed to the executive room, leaving the band without a bassist. It happened, but not like that.
Yeah, okay.
But it really happened.
Oh, but we situation, but we situation by Ahala, so by Bonai. So you had to discipline.
It's just a way of putting them on the line.
Okay.
They told you that.
A situation where you hold a drummer from behind the curtain. Do you remember that story? When the drummer was playing, you went in and hold him with the curtain. Can you please confirm?
Who told you that one?
No, but it's stuff that I have on my archives, you know?
Yeah, that happened.
I'm not gonna say that, you know. Because there's another bass player that had the same experience like Lundi.
Yeah,
but it's okay.
Let's leave it at that.
You guys,
I mean, we had a drive to Jay Tlengwane's funeral. I don't wanna go in. I don't wanna go and really, yeah. I think let's leave it there. Mthunzi, I think those are just a few videos that we wanted to play from the other guys that really wanted to share. And I mean, there's still a lot of them that we didn't even play here. But we'll play them one day. Maybe when we go to TV, we'll repeat this whole thing and then just have you and then have everyone coming in and have everyone singing. I know a lot of people wanted to, and now in different years, you had too many of us. We had many of us that came in and played sort of like a slash call music director during your performances. And I just want to double check if Josie, are you ready? I want to play just one song as a tribute from one of your boys, who really. Actually he sent a message, so I couldn't play his message, I couldn't sync his message, but I thought I will leave his, he did a small rendition for you. I just want to double check if Lebu Josie is ready, because after this I'm gonna need him to share his screen and share some of his videos that he that he put together. Josie, are you ready?
Yeah, I'm considerably ready.
Oh, okay. So I'll play just one of my video and then unshare the screen, and then you will share your screen and play some of the videos that you have that side. And then after those videos, and then we'll go back to talk. And then after talk, we'll play just our last celebration song that we did. And then we'll be ending the show. let me play. This is a video from Wanda Kwela. I'm definitely sure you remember him, so he's your son. Let me play. It's a very short clip, so let me just play it.
Okay.
What a wonderful day. It will be all heaven and earth. Proclaim with grace, troubles will be all over. No more pain, soon we'll be changed to be like him.
Whoa.
Ish. Yes.
What happened there?
Oh, I'm sorry. Oh, is it only on my side or everyone's side?
It's everywhere.
Everywhere. Okay.
It's everywhere.
I'm sorry, guys. Let me just double check. I think everything just went mute on my side. it's just that now I don't, the only place where I can play it is through this. Okay, let's do this. Mm-hmm. Let me sort it out. Let's jump to you, Josie, so I can sort it out, because it's a different file. You know, I was struggling to play it. I had to put it on this software for me to be able to play it. Apologies. Wow. I'll play it again. Josie, can you please share your screen and share some of the videos?
Am I playing everything that's in my life right now?
Okay, because the video is playing now. Should I attempt to play it again?
Please try.
Okay. Apologies, guys. Like we said, there's no software that can handle our minds, really. Let me try it again. Let's see if it will work.
What a wonderful day. It will be all heaven and earth. Proclaim with grace, troubles will be all over. No more pain, soon we'll be changed to be like him when he comes. When he comes with grace and power.
I will lift up mine eyes to the hills, from whence cometh thy help. My help, it comes from the Lord. It comes from the Lord. I will lift up mine eyes to the hills, from whence cometh my help. My help, it comes from the Lord. My help comes from the Lord.
Woo. Whoa.
So you shall up for now, Mfundisi. So
whoa.
You shall up for
whoa.
Now.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. Wow.
I know. We end Zealand.
So hey. he took. Do you remember some of those songs? Do you remember some?
Of course.
Do you want to say something about them?
Ooh, you see the first part, What a Wonderful Day. I remember very clearly, even when that song came, I was in New York, in Brooklyn.
Do you remember?
Okay, someone's mic. Okay.
And that song just came like that. And, you know, so, I mean, when I had Wanda doing this, I was like, oh my God. And the vocal arrangement, beautiful. I remember. So, oh, I'm blown. That's beautiful.
Hey, no, oh, Siamo. Josie, are you ready?
I am.
Okay, please play some of the videos, some of the videos from your side.
I feel the anointing, the anointing, and it's moving in this place. I feel the anointing, the anointing, and it's moving in this place. Touch me, oh Jesus, oh Lord Jesus, oh touch me now, I pray. Touch me, oh Jesus, oh Jesus, touch.
That was
wow.
Pause a bit. Josie, can you hear me?
Sure.
Yes, I can hear you.
Mfundi, so that was Mabongi Mabaso. I don't know if you know her. You know her, right?
Yeah.
Yes. She.
In fact, she there's a song Sabu and I have been talking about.
Yeah.
And I was saying to him, who can do this song? And he kept on saying, Mabongi, 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 Mabongi. I know her. Yeah.
Yeah. So I think
I've never worked with her though. You know?
I think she's already auditioned. Please make it happen. It wasn't an audition, but you know, now that at least she confirmed a song, okay, let's just make it happen.
In fact, Lebo did the instrumentation of that song. You'll remember Lebu and the song Utando. That song. He's not listening. Fine.
Well, Ulebu is not here for this. He's just
a silent
partner.
that's amazing.
Oh, wow.
Josie, please play the next one.
All right.
Umasi.
these are some of the people that you worked with, and yeah, it was quite an emotional one when we were thinking about it. And
right.
I know that some of them we don't know them, but or we couldn't find and their pictures.
Right.
Like Sihle Kunene, we couldn't get his picture, but right. I remember he was one of the guitarists that you work with.
In fact, you know, the last picture of Ne, you ended with Ne. It just brought back memories.
Yes.
You know, because actually, I'm the first one who worked with him.
Yeah.
He was studying here in Durban, and I was working for Ukos FM. He was doing his practicals, you know, because he did engineering and all those things. And I needed a voice for something, for some jingles. And he happened to be there. I didn't know who he was. He introduced himself. So I started working with him then. Then I took him to Family Factory.
Hmm.
Then from Family Factory to Joyous. So it's, yeah, amazing.
Yeah, because I saw some of the videos of Family Factory. He was really young.
Yeah, he was.
Wendy Mselegu.
Wendy Mselegu. I remember when I joined Sony Music, she was amongst, I think she was the third artist we signed after Sibongile Khumalo. I think it was Mdu Tsiki Tsiki, and it was Sibongile Khumalo, and it was Wendy Mselegu. So I worked with her right from the beginning on her first project. Wendy Mselegu, like my younger sister kind of thing.
Yeah.
You know why? Yeah, she was even a family of Ubo, because the fact that they're coming, she was born in Durban and raised in Lamontville. No mama can babu. So imagine Mtuana. As a matter of fact, her first car was the car she bought from me. A Honda Ballad. Yeah, she was not even licensed. Somebody else was driving the car. Amazing. Yeah.
And Sihle, how did you guys meet? No, Sihle, I mean, we saw him with Sihle. That solo. I want to talk about that song as well. How did it come about, the song? It's just that now we don't have it. We could play it, actually.
Emmanuel.
Yes.
Sihle, I met him at the University of Zululand. He had worked in Mfundisi Uchabo. They had a group called Essence, I think. That's what it was called at that time, and Sihle came to study music, and we needed a bass guitarist, and he could play guitar as well, but we needed a bass guitarist to come in, because a guy always had a bass, but we needed someone more contemporary. So Sihle came on board, and that's the first time I met him. Then we pulled him in to gospel music, Nasenkonzweni, you know, then Tutugo was there, we were born again, and we're pulling him to be part of what we were doing. So that's, then when he completed, of course, was like Ekoli, when I was doing the album Gachabu, the first album, Nkosi Yokuthula, I think it was called, Sihle had worked on some songs with Uchabu. So we brought him in to come and be part of the project as well. That's the time when I had worked with him at the university, but then that's when we took it even further. That was a brilliant interpretation of Ezulina Weshugana.
Yeah, wonderful. I think that's one of my personal songs. And there's another one that we there's too many of them that we attempted to do, but because of time, we couldn't get through to them. I remember Modimo, Ria Holebo, Hahayo, Yatwala.
Oh, yeah. And,
oh, it was a beautiful song. It was a beautiful song. I think the other one that I used to look forward to playing, actually, well, I think at the time, playing playing brass with a keyboard was an amazing thing, was a beautiful thing. Calm down, my lord. used to be very interesting.
Yeah, very, very interesting. Yeah, you know, I there was remember a, that, yeah.
Josie, you want to follow up quickly before we move?
Oh, that was good, Josie. Amazing.
Blessed a lot. No, I don't have a follow up actually.
But a follow up.
Hey, but I wanna as Luin, I remember that song with your ass, man. Yo.
Yeah. No.
Now you just mentioned also with the more demo.
Yes.
Yeah. So, demo.
In the key of D.
In the key of D, poet.
You just took us back. And come down, my lord. The drumming. Yeah.
Oh.
Gwazi Shang. Mfundisi needs to tell us a little bit about Gwazi.
Oh,
yes. Tell us about Gwazi, Mfundisi.
Gwazi. You know, there are those kinds of musicians. When you have them behind you, you would know that they would be able to follow and understand where you're going. Ugwazi, you can understand that Ugwazi was playing with a lot of musicians who are not doing gospel, Abo Miriam Makeba and all that, and all those artists. And when I pulled him into gospel, I had seen him play, but we had not worked together. So when I pulled him in to work with me, man, that guy will play drums as if he had a click track on his head.
Yeah.
And keep the time. Oh my God. I mean, you can understand those days, there was no sequencing. That guy was playing. For me, Gwazi is one of the best drummers I've ever had. But the beauty, then when Ngubeko came and joined the band, and the bass guitarists were different because we had Chris and sometimes another bassist. But when they were there and Gwazi was there, oh man, same with Joyous. You would know that you would miss Gwazi when he's not there.
Oh,
you know, yeah. when he got ill, my heart was so sad. Was so sad because we were busy talking about doing other things. And oh man, yeah.
I remember I was part of the band when Gwazi was there and Mbata and Chris. Right.
And Chris, yeah.
It was really beautiful. I told myself I don't want to mention the story, but I won't mention it. I won't give details. I'll just browse on top of it. I remember, actually, let me not tell the story because hey, it's going to expose some other things. Let me just say, I remember how you were strict on not having another drama. I mean, there was a point where you used to cancel a gig because Gwazi is not available, you know, and it used to be really hard because we attempted different dramas and it never worked out. It always backfired, especially at the right. Cool I used to suggest, but hey, we forced the gig. No, let's do it. I'll get someone. I'll get who. Hey, and my son's a stage in here with, hey man, hey, there's no jail here, man. We miss that metronome, you know that?
That metronome, yeah.
What an experience.
In fact, it's amazing you mentioned that because when Gwazi, just before he passed on, before he got ill, I remember at one point we had finished a gig and he called me and he said, hey, Namba, when I'm fit, I'm at drums. And your was literally a set drum like I tatted 2 hours.
Yeah.
I didn't want to let drum fit. Give a little Jehovah head to manch. Mm-hmm. You know? And you could see Uguti, something was beginning to happen in his spirit. And he said to me, Can you please pray for these drums? And when he finished playing, he wouldn't like anyone to touch them. He would spend 2 hours alone just putting things together. He was very, very committed in what he was doing.
Yo.
Amazing.
Yeah. Yo. Great memories there.
Yeah.
Great definitely. Memories. Thank you, Mfundisi. You know, I think we're going towards the end, but there's something else. There's a last song that we'll play. I want to ask you a question, Jay, a silly question, Jay. When you open your iPod or your iPhone, what is a good product and what is a bad product according to you? And now in 2020, obviously, not really mentioning names, what sounds off for you? What sounds good to your ears?
Say that again.
If
put
you
that
open
question
your,
differently.
What is a you good product in terms of you listening now with an ear, producer's ear? What is a good product and what is a bad product according to you?
Well, for me, a good product is a product that achieves its purpose. Mm. If you're doing a song that wants to entertain people, you know, what will make it effective would be if it achieves what it was composed or written for. Mm. Now, when you take that to gospel music, what will sound good is, apart from the technical things, that it's well mixed, it's well interpreted. I would start by listening to the song, and then from there I would get to analyze the song and begin to pick up stuff, you know, things like interpretation, things like dynamics. And for me, it would be, if it's gospel, I don't know how, I would find myself listening to the lyrics as well and see if they're scriptural or they're not scriptural. Because for me, I believe what really makes a gospel song is when a song carries the word.
Mm.
That would be my definition. When it carries the word, and that word is a word, whether it's a word of hope, word of faith, you know, encouragement, whatever it is, edification, I would tend to, even at our church, I can just make you aware, there'll be times when I tell Bazalwane, "Hey, Bazalwane, bengicela singaliculi le mculo." And the guys who will be leading, they will find themselves confused. I know that this song is popular out there, but for me, it does nothing to the soul of a man. Then I would say, no, let's not do that song. Mm. Let's find songs that carry life. Mm. You know, so yeah.
So I'm sure it's hard to be a worship leader in your church with all the experience. Because now I'm just thinking now, what song if then I'm singing next to the key, if I'm singing next to the key, how do you approach it when the service is on?
You see, think about it. There are songs which are popular, which, as far as I'm concerned, they are empty.
Mm.
They can sell, but in terms of, particularly because we're talking about gospel music, and some of them, you'll find that even scripturally, they are wrong.
Mm.
Even scripturally, they are wrong. And that's not what the scripture is saying. If I can, I don't even want to quote and mention those songs. But for me, again, it's not like it's difficult to be a worship leader, because you would now have to understand what worship is. Because my preaching and my teaching is that every born again Christian, whether playing an instrument or not, is a worshiper. So for me, the idea of having the other guys can be called worship leaders, but we are all worshipers. So for me, it's not a umama or at the back can start a song. And people, the shackles in people's lives would be broken. And that song was not rehearsed. It's a song that was just somehow triggered by the Holy Spirit. So it's not a question of, for me, worship is not a chain of songs that have been prepared, that have been rehearsed 2 weeks before. And then we call that worship. That's not worship. It's actually performance.
Butter.
Mfundis, there's one of the things that Mfundis Namba has really done well, but I'm in no position maybe to judge whether you Mthunzi has done well or not. But translating English songs into Zulu, it's so amazing how you've done it. I'm thinking about the song that you did with Joyous Lelithi, was a Masingen. When you look at it in English version of that,
in English,
sometimes it's a big struggle for us as writers, composers, and musical directors to do a proper translation where you can hear that every word in this song works,
just as it worked
when it was in English.
In English, you know what? Right.
Yeah, it. Some of these things they work in English. Once we try to translate them into Zulu or another language,
it just doesn't work.
The whole song,
it doesn't work.
Precious Jesus, you know.
Right.
You've done a translation of that. You know. Could you maybe take us through your thinking process when it comes to that? It's amazing how you do it.
It's a good example. Those songs you mentioning. I think the main thing there is not to translate word by word. Some words will fit, some words will not. So the whole idea is, what is the meaning of that verse? If there is that verse, it has 8 lines, what is the meaning? What message is it carrying? So that as you go to come, let us enter into the presence, woza masingene, ebukhoneni benkosi. So again, you look at, If I go and translate it word by word, then it's not going to fit. And remember that there has to be that marriage of the syllables. The word itself must go along with the melody. Because when it's forced, you're going to hear it. There's going to be that uneasiness. It's not going to settle, and the reason would be you have used a wrong word, whereas you could have borrowed a different word and put it in there, and you don't lose the meaning of the whole phrase. So it's a matter of just finding the right word that works with the melody itself, because it must flow with that melodic line, and once it's forced, you will hear it. But it's amazing that you say it's not an easy thing. I'll be honest with you, it's not. Sometimes I would do a translation, keep singing it, and leave it. Come back the next day. When I come back the next day, I'll be inspired to come up with a different word. Because remember, with singing, Zulu has got so many. It has consonants and different in the syllables and vowels and all those things. You find that what you say in English is shorter than how you say it in Zulu or Sotho, whatever. So you'll have to now try and say, okay, let me get that word. That word means the same thing, though it's different. It's not what is on the song. Then you take that, you put it in, sing it, then it will come together.
Josie?
But still, on the, just to go back to that subject when you were speaking about worship, which I thought was quite poignant and significant.
Volume, please.
Volume, okay. I'm doing that. Is it okay?
Yeah.
Okay. I was just wondering if you could make a comment, because one of the things that is growing in popularity in what we consider worship, in not just in the country but in the world, is this approach of merging emotionalism into our worship ministry. It's like it's an imperative that if you're gonna worship, somebody must cry. If you're gonna worship, you measure your effectiveness by how much makeup is messed up. I don't know. Do you have a comment that you could put in on that?
Phew, Josie. Yeah. it's just that what is in Christendom, what at the present moment, what it's called worship isn't worship. Isn't worship, because once you, you know, Jesus made a statement in John chapter 4, when you read verse 21 and verse 22, when he met with this woman, a Samaritan lady, coming to draw water. You know the story. And then Jesus talks about, they talk about this racism thing, you are a Jew, I'm Samaritan, and blah, blah, blah. And then Jesus slowly, he was changing the discussion, slowly, slowly, that he gets into the issue of where is your husband and all that, you know the story. And then suddenly they get into the issue of worship. Then when they get into the issue of worship, Jesus makes a statement. He says, if you knew who's asking for water, you would be asking water from me. And then this lady says, okay, give me, the water I can give you, it will make you not to thirst again. Then now he takes it to the issue of worship. And he says, the time is coming, as if he's predicting in the future. Then he says, now it has come. Now he says, the time is coming. Now, when he says the time is coming, it's as if he's talking before the time came. And then when he says, now it has come, that they that worship him must worship him in spirit and in truth. And you hear that now, he takes it to another level. He says, he did not say they that worship him must worship him in song. He did not say they worship him must worship him in melody. David talks about the melody. He talks, I will bless the Lord, and da da da. But when Jesus takes, he says, they that worship him must worship him in spirit and in truth. Then he goes profound. He says, it becomes profound. He says, for the Father seeketh such that they that worship. Now he's now bringing in the issue in answering you, Josie, of true worship by true worshipers.
Amen.
It's not now worship by musicians. It's true worship by true worshipers. And it says the Father is looking for true worshipers. Then once I hear a statement like that, I always pause and say, if they are true worshipers, it means they are false worshipers. Absolutely. Now, false worshipers will be those who have not, they don't have surrendered hearts. Meaning, a person comes to church, that is what I'm saying, when we get into that issue, is a very different issue, because what we hear and what is called worship, which is coupled by emotionalism, the reason why people get emotional and then they say, I feel the Holy Spirit, and whereas it's just goosebumps. it's not the Holy Spirit. And who said when the Holy Spirit comes, you must begin to shake? Who says when the Holy Spirit comes, you must be, your makeup must be messed up? I'm not saying when the Holy Spirit comes, this. Now remember, which is again another wrong notion within the Christendom. That's why I don't sing songs like Yehla Moya Ngcwele, because the Holy Spirit has already come. But yet people still sing Yehla Moya Ngcwele. He has already come, and listen, I'm gonna say something very funny, because when the Lord challenged me about it, Oza Masingene Ebukhoneni Benkosi, you don't enter into the presence, because the Holy Spirit now lives on the inside. Meaning, because he is on the inside, you have a surrendered heart. So now what makes you a true worshiper is not how well you sing or how well rehearsed you are. It will be how well surrendered you are before God. Why? Because remember that music is a very, very delicate issue of discussion, because it's a territory that Satan, who was Lucifer, knows very well. He understands it so well, and he understands the power and the benefit of true worship. That is why even when he met Jesus, you know, when Jesus was led by the Spirit, the Bible says to be tempted, after where he fasted for 40 days and 40 nights, the devil takes him through many things, but then he zooms in on the main thing. If you will bow down and worship me, I'll give you these. Now, when you look at that, then you will begin to understand that worship, as a matter of fact, is all about a heart and a body that has been surrendered to God. Therefore, then the Holy Spirit takes your fingers, takes your vocal cords, takes your drumming. He anoints it, which means now he becomes the one. It's no longer you playing. It's him playing through you, because now Christ resides in us. Mm. Now, when that happens, maybe let me just put a pause there and take it to another area. The danger of this is that when Satan was thrown out of heaven, after he became proud, and then the Bible tells us that he was thrown out of heaven because of pride. But the main thing is he understood how to worship God. Now that he's taken out of heaven, all that he's looking for people inside the church he can possess. In other words, he's looking for containers that he can possess, and they will be in the church drunk and lead worship. And then it's like he is saying to God, you threw me out so that I cannot worship you. Fine, I'm gonna still worship you through these vessels that are not surrendered to you. So now what happens is, that is why a person will lead worship and come out of leading worship and go and drink. Lead worship, after leading worship, go to whatever, all evil you can imagine. Then for me, then it says, like Tolly was saying initially, that with Ichuba, which is again the symbol of the Holy Spirit, the Holy Spirit is here. The Holy Spirit will, he does not come down now. He manifests his presence, but he will never do that in a place, Josie, I'm coming back to you now, in a place where there is evil and darkness. The truth of the matter is that what is going on in Christendom is not true worship. That is why, so it's like people come there and they lift up their hands. And as they lift up their hands, what is actually happening when some of them are crying, it's because the spirit on the inside is actually crying. I am not what I'm supposed to be. I am starving. I need the presence of God. Now, what happens there now is talent without the oil, without the anointing, because the Holy Spirit, the truth is, cannot dwell in a vessel that is not clean. So it's only the idea. Concert, because of the jargon that is the language, the lingua that is being used in the church. All that people call that. That's not the Holy Spirit. Now, can I just say to the people out there who are young, aspiring musicians, always remember this. The spiritual thing is about a battle for bodies. Meaning, if I can simplify what I'm saying, whoever indwells you, the same will control you. So the one who is living in you is the one who will control you. If the Holy Spirit is in you, now there's a difference here, because the Holy Spirit indwells a person, but Satan possesses the person. So let me show you, Josie, your question is, what we see in gospel concerts. That is why, Bazalwane, if truth be told, we will not see eyes opening during our gospel concerts. We will not see, we don't see people standing up from wheelchairs. We don't see tumors busting or whatever, because of deliverance that is carried by the power of a godly music. I want to qualify it. That is why we don't see that. Why? Because we come, whatever we do is all about making the flesh jump and getting tickled. That is why you see in churches, everything that you see in the world has infiltrated the church. Even the issue of lighting, how the stage is designed, it's no longer about glorifying the man Christ Jesus. It's no longer about the glory of Christ. It's all about this must look good. This must be like this. And yeah, I hope Jose, I've answered you.
You have. You have. And consequently triggered a lot of other questions. But I don't know, Tabet.
One more, Jose. We're going towards the end now.
I think just since we're in that neighborhood, one of the things I think I'm recently learning in my study of worship was how we tend to separate the spiritual expression from the physical expression in our worship. And I remember one friend of mine, I saw him on a video. He was saying, every other religion, when they go to their God, they bow, like literally physically bowing in Islam.
Right.
And he says, we speak about bowing more than any other religion, but we actually do not do it. Just maybe also a comment on that. How significant is our physical expression in communicating worship? Like you quoted Matthew, where the devil says to Jesus, he doesn't say, sing a song for me of worship. He doesn't
exactly.
Say, yeah, he doesn't say give a tithe. It's like bow and
gives us an understanding that worship is not necessarily about singing.
Yes, absolutely.
Worship is not necessarily about playing. You could be worshiping, not even singing a melody. Have you noticed this? That whenever the scripture gives us the glimpse of heaven. I like what you've just said, Josie. Whenever the Bible, for example, in Revelation chapter 5, from verse 8 to 14, where the Bible talks about who is worthy to open the seal. And then immediately when you go down the verses, like verse 12, 13, you will hear that suddenly all the creatures around the throne were bowing down and saying, holy, 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 holy. And when you go to Revelation chapter 15, you start again reading from verse 3 to 4. Whenever we are shown a glimpse of what is happening around heaven, or what is happening rather in heaven around the throne, all that you see here is a celebration of the glory of Christ. And it's that kind of bowing. In Greek, they call it to barak, where you go before God, where you say, I am not worthy to stand in your presence. Then now it calls for you to bow down. You are even, you remember Isaiah, when he saw the Lord, he started seeing how wicked he is. Worship must cause us because it's all about intimacy. As we try to get closer to God, you will realize that, let me put it this way, Josie, when we are really worshiping, there won't be noise. And again, number two, when he has manifested, no one can be able to stand and go around and go, Yibaba, shasha. Why? Because when he manifests his presence, listen, it's certain we don't understand. When God manifests his presence, when he manifests his presence, no one can remain standing. Everyone will run and go down. Why? Because his glory, the light he carries, shines upon us and it reveals how dirty we are. Then we feel unworthy. Now, then It takes us to Hebrews. By grace and by his mercy, now we can enter the throne because of the blood. That's the blood now that washes us, And as it washes us, then we can begin to get closer. We're drawing closer. It's a process. Now, I think the biggest problem is that uNkulunkulu sesimjwayela kabi.
Yeah.
We even honor and respect our pastors more than we actually revere our maker.
Can we sit on that for 2 seconds? I think there's something to be said there.
Yeah.
You want me to continue?
Yeah, that
yeah,
that,
because the reverence
is gone, yeah.
The reverence is gone. Why? Because the focus, oh my God, the focus, and again, I always say this, that we as pastors will be accountable one day before God, because we are calling people to us. It's all about the men of God and the women of God. The attention is on the pastor. Jesus said, when I'm lifted up, I will draw men. Now, we don't draw men. What we do, no man, there's no one who's drawn to God. Why? Because we use other means of drawing people. When we see crowds coming, it's not because Jesus has drawn them. That is why they come into the church. They live the same, unchanged. Why? Because the reverence and the fear of the Lord has gone out of what is called church, not the building, church, the body of Christ. We don't revere who he is. All we do is we can actually, oh man of God. As you say, Josie, when the song says, bow down before him, when the song says, masikotame, people don't do that, because what they are singing, like the Bible says, they are worshiping me with their lips, but their hearts, it's the heart issue. Their hearts are far away. While they are leading worship in the church, a person who leading worship, so there isn't a relationship, intimate issue. The reverence is gone. We serve our pastors, but we don't serve the one who bought us our salvation through his life.
Yeah, absolutely.
I've requested that people can send their questions shortly. We are left with a few minutes, and I see people are asking a wrong question. People are, they're saying their question is, can we have part three? And I'm saying, that is not a question. That is definitely not a question. But there's a question that came in here, which I know that a lot of people are dealing with, and it's from Siyabonga Suks. He's asking, what's the connection between sex and worship? Most wonderful worshippers fall to this sin. What's the stronghold in this?
Sure.
It's quite a
tricky You remember I mentioned something that it's all about who indwells you. Have you noticed that it's a very, very, I won't be able to answer all of it now, but have you noticed that I mentioned that Lucifer, Satan, who was Lucifer then, when he fell, when you read in Ezekiel chapter 28 and you read in Isaiah chapter 14, you'll find that the way he was adorned, the way he was created, the Bible says, the way God formed him, he carried this beauty. That is why now, because he fell and he lost the presence of God, and then he was thrown into the earth, his sin was pride. Because his sin was pride. He causes people who are in this, again, music, particularly music, he causes them to be one, full of pride, two, to be self-engrossed. In other words, to be, he makes them to look upon themselves and see the beauty in themselves. That is why music will always be accompanied with a lot of makeup, with a lot of the kind of regalia, the kind of costumes that are these days, even in Christendom, people wearing costumes that are defining. And the reason is the devil knows very well that once he catches someone with the person who asked mentioned the word stronghold, but once he, let's call it sin, it's the sin of sexual immorality, which that sexual immorality, as the Bible says, when you go and read in Colossians chapter 5, when it mentions all those kinds of sins, one of them is sexual immorality. It says such people will not enter. Now, here's the question. The people that are leading worship, as my fellow brother asked the question, the way they will sing will be because there is no surrendering of the heart. Like there is no offering God praise from the heart that is pure. There is no purity. All that the devil will do, he will make sure he understands the power of, I said earlier on, is the question of the heart. He understands the power of a heart that is polluted, that will release a song that will be polluted. And then suddenly, this question is, that is why you find that most of the people that lead worship in churches and pastors look at them as powerful worship leaders, all of them, most of them, let me not say all of them, most of them have a weakness when it comes to sex, when it comes to sexual immorality. And that's one thing that the devil has managed in Christendom to control and destroy churches. That's what the devil has managed. That's what he's using. That's one of the tools he's using. Because the moment a person has been delivered from that, then that person, Romans 12 says, verse 1, I urge you, brethren, that you offer, listen to this, your bodies as what? As living sacrifice. And then he does not end there. He says, holy, acceptable, and pleasing to the Lord. Meaning, don't bring a prostituted body and expect that that body will be able to carry a melody that is godly. That is why Paul there says, I urge you, present your body. Like I said, that the devil is after bodies. He is a spirit. He is after those he can live in and then make them, now listen to this, make them become his agents who will spread sexual immorality. Now, Paul says, offer your body, one, as a living sacrifice, which means a person can offer a body that is a dead sacrifice. As a living sacrifice, then he takes it to another level, holy, which means righteous, which means holy, pure, acceptable to God. Meaning, as you lead worship, God is not turning his back and saying, I'm not going to receive that because it's coming from a vessel that is not clean. I hope I answered you.
I would like to believe that he's really answered and it has opened our eyes.
So there is a connection.
Mm-hmm.
Two comments on that.
You're saying two comments on what?
on the answer. I thought just as a Okay, are we about to close? I think I might take time. All right, next question, Koi.
Can I give you a minute whilst I'm sorting out the next thing that is about to happen now and then going towards closing?
Who, me?
Yes. Yes.
Oh, yeah. Okay. Oh, okay. Yeah, no. I really love the item of the clothes. I thought I should pass there being an anti-uniform activist in the body of Christ at Bazalon.
Right.
The man of God. Hey, his gowns.
What? And Starblack.
Yeah, these Starblacks and things. Can we be delivered lest the enemy has an advantage over us because we are not ignorant of his devices. So I thought I should.
So are you, just, you're against all the that uniform?
I'm not a fan of uniform as a concept.
Right.
I think we should try to tone it down. So when you said sometimes hey man, uniforms have a stronghold. The men of God just pointed out. Lucifer, and the Bible says, how art thou fallen, Lucifer, you son of the morning?
But this uniform, when they came, it was because they were fighting another side of the stronghold.
Yeah.
They were trying to bring a solution.
What, of competition?
Of competition? Yes, Mthunzi, yeah.
Well, I see the issue of the uniform is not... It's just that now the issue of the uniform has been taken to... My only concern is one. Mm-hmm. The world has infiltrated the church.
Mm.
That's my concern. That everything, the way people are dressing, the so-called gospel musicians, it's not on. It's not good. It's not presentable. It's not presentable. And I think it's because we have embraced too much of worldliness. You know, that's why Paul says, don't conform to the standard of the world. But that's what we're doing. We're looking at what Kim Kardashian will put on, something that is too revealing. Suddenly you go around town, everyone is wearing that. You understand? So the issue of the uniform per se is not wrong, you know, but at the same time,
Sibe careful what to agenda because uchose akse kutuni inkinga nje uniform vele. I think nje vele akayithandi nje into ehlangene ukugcoka ngendlela ethize ukuthi simeshe masifike egigini nje elithize akayifuni nje. Ya singayithathi ngenye level spiritual because ayikho special.
No, just also, it's not rebellion, but it's not rebellion. You remember when David had to fight Goliath? They recommended an attire.
Okay, I know what you're saying.
That was very relevant.
It's okay.
And he tried the attire.
Let's hand it over to Cody.
He did not kill the giant with the attire.
Take it over, Pastor.
Oli, over to you.
Okay, asivaleni mfundisi, asivaleni ngoba. I think I will request you to pray after this rendition we've put together, and I said there's so many songs that we couldn't even touch on. Starting from Uyinkosi Yamakhosi, because I first heard it when I heard Sweet Waters back in the days. Can we help those who always find themselves stealing someone's song and they said it's their song? Can you please clarify this? Is Uyinkosi Yamakhosi your composition or was someone else's composition? You had to rework it.
It's my composition.
From scratch the end.
From scratch to the end.
Yes, I needed to. Yes, I needed you to say that because we have a situation we give you all the glory, You Are Alpha and Omega, which we know that was written by Lucky Khadebe. Is it Pastor Lucky? Am I right, Josie?
Yes, Pastor
Lucky Khadebe. And Israel picked it up from Zimbabwe, and I heard with someone in Zimbabwe claimed that it's his song. And
it's his song, yeah.
And now the song is the biggest song now globally. But the actual person that wrote it is from Israel here. And now you find that all these songs, the Zialahleka, someone said, I think Umoja Love, one of the shows there, he wrote a song. I don't remember if it was Jehovah Jireh or what. I know the actual person that wrote the song. So I will not say that the guy was lying or not, but I am just putting it out there because that's why I'm trying to clarify this, because a lot of
songs... Right, right.
You just say the truth you know is not the same as the one he spoke.
So, yeah, she said, I don't want to phrase. I don't want to phrase, but I'm just putting it out there that let's be careful... just because Pumango era it is a singer kogio leo era, and then we say, oh, this was manza a tini ingo my tis a yako intatekimang yakaka when was written by Oba Sitela. But I see a lot of people are saying it's a public domain, it's not a public domain, it was written by someone, and they get lanuk recording as Trelanga is ngom. I don't know, Mfundisi. I know that you did a lot of rearrangements throughout your producing life. You did your undercrowd, you did your
Richard Smallwood.
Yes,
you did a lot of those things. What was the concept behind? Actually, I'm supposed to be closing now. I'm asking a question.
You're asking questions now.
Yeah.
but I like what you're saying, Uguti. You can use someone else's song credit,
yeah,
rather than claiming, you know. But I mean, we've been victims of that. We know that.
Yeah.
But I like it when you tell people Uguti Mama Yege to do that.
Yeah, ngiyacela ukuthi abayeke. By the president, my cool amazing to baziyeke. So not a smanele with the abayegizin. Mark figured this was cut in the so was on to join Chingom of a Lufagi mask. Let's try with Seafag. Why, Jonchi? Funis, there's a rendition here. I'm nervous actually because I'm singing, and but we've put together with everyone. I think you know pretty much everyone on the video except few people that helped us put it together. Again, it's some of the songs that you composed and rearranged and everything. Let me just play it and then we'll close after. We'll come back and close. Let me share the screen quickly. All right, there we go.
Sometimes in life, the rain will come, and all the friends you had are gone. There is one thing I need you to know. There is a God who knows it all. I need to hear somebody pray. I need to hear somebody pray. When I came down, gone. I need to hear somebody pray. For me to live, I know it's Christ. for me to die. I know it's game. There is one thing I need to show. There is a friend who knows it all. Situation you're going through. Somebody pray. It doesn't matter what's happening around you, but you need to pray. Storms may come, but I need to hear. Oh, I need to hear. I need to hear. Somebody pray. Just hold on to his unfailing love. Somebody pray. It reminds me of the song. Come on, say. Yeah. You gotta pray. God loves you.
Short the pain for our sake.
lay your hands on me. I want to know you more. Lay your hand on me. This is my plea. Lay your hand on me. I just want to know you more. Lay your hand on me. This is my plea. Lay your hand.
Lay your hand on me.
Yes, lay your hand on me.
I just want to be like you.
Lay your hand on me.
Lay your hand on me.
This is my plea.
This is my plea.
Lay your hand on me.
Lay your hand on me.
I just want to know.
I want to know you more and more.
Lay your hand on me.
Lay your hand on me.
This is my plea.
This is my plea.
Come on, let's sing together. Lay your hand on me.
Lay your hand on me.
Oh. Know you more and more. Lay your hand on me, yeah. Lay your hand on me. This is my plea.
This is my plea.
Lay your hand on me. Oh, I just wanna.
I want to know you more and more.
Lay your hand on me. Lay your hand
on me.
This is my plea.
This is my plea. Yo, sure.
Hey, yeah, whoa. No.
Well,
hey, amazing. Amazing. Very humbling.
We just had to put something together. And,
that was lovely.
We had to ask all the guys that you saw there. We had Mbata,
we had
Sabu, we had Bega.
I can see. Yes.
We had Gama.
Tutugo, Tamini.
Hey, this is Peter Wandaba, right, Lapa. Sure. Short of what sends in jail, maybe the live.
The live, yes. Wow.
So short of jail. But again, as a budget, you make a problem. So that's a budget. Yeah, because it was the when I have been.
What a tribute.
So what's the engine?
Can you believe it?
So that's a budget. So that's a when.
So that's a budget, Gabab.
So that's a budget, Gabab.
Imalis, I told.
Yeah,
thank you very much. It's very humbling. Thank you to all the guys. Wow, wow, beautiful. Beautiful.
Yeah, no, it was strong. Hey, that bass was.
Basically. Yeah, it was present.
I know.
That's no, amazing. Amazing.
But I. Beautiful.
Siyabonga bafowethu man. Siyabonga Bega. I know that Bega is there. Thank you so much. And we had the young lady by Umutsuwedi. She
lovely singing.
She did the arrangements and we had Mobile as well, just making overdubbing the voices as well. So
beautiful. Thank you guys to all of you. Thank you very much. Yes. The Lord bless you and increase you. Thank you very much.
Amazing. Tandazele mfundisi,
blessing.
Something because me invite you.
Yeah, now we invite
you. I just want to say thank you to these guys, man. Koli, man, you guys, Koli, Lebu, and Joseph, Aaron. Though we don't hear a lot of your voice, but we can see a lot of your work. Thank you so much for this initiative, Mpela. You know, it's good what you guys did for our father, Mfundisi Namba, whilst he's alive. You know, I think this is the beginning of many tributes, Mfundisi, that it's been in our heart to do a lot of things for you. And thank you guys for coming with this one and making me part of it.
Yeah.
It's such an honor for me to be part of it. Thank you guys for this initiative. You guys are doing an amazing job. Well done. Thank you so much.
Siyabonga mfundisi Namba, singaqedi ukubonga kodwa wena. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Ngempela Namba, just to reiterate what Ngubengo has just said, thank you very much. I think what you're doing, like we spoke earlier, which it's amazing that we as South Africans, we don't do these things much. You know, it's very, very humbling. May the Lord really bless you and keep doing the good work. It's amazing. It's amazing.
Siyabonga mfundisi, siyabonga kakhulu, sithunyiwe. Sithunyiwe. So sithandile kakhulu ukuthi senze I sikhavare kahle. And I know that the show has been taking longer. Guys, thank you so much for staying in, and Mbatha siyabonga ndoda, you know, for making sure that you make yourself available as well. And respond to the request as well. Thank you so much. Mfundisi, thank you as well for agreeing to this. And I know that you had a busy schedule. We attempted to do episode 2 on Friday and it just couldn't work out. But today it has worked out perfectly, and it gave us time as well to prep ourselves. And we send people, I mean, like specifically with the song as well, I mean, we sent Mbatha a skeleton that just had a funny voice. We sent the others. I remember even with Upega, I sent him something that was wrong, that didn't have drums, you know, and there was a lot of back and forth. And everyone really, even the guys that I called, Bishop Stephen, Brenda, Sabata, Sfiso.
Right.
I mean, there's too many of them that we called, and everyone was just excited. And we just want to say thank you to them as well. Thanks to Mabongi as well.
Thank you.
To Siba. There's too many of them that just made this thing possible. So we felt Nati as well, but last week wasn't enough without us involving the music part. Yeah.
Right. We really wanted it was amazing.
Yes, we wanted to wrap it nicely. Patrice is on the TV. Sizoyenza ke sekusinika budget kababa ne budget kamfowethu noma umuphi umfowethu uzobe usadecidile ukusinika imali. So siyabonga kakhulu. Thank you guys for tuning in, and mfundisi sicela ukuyivala ngomthandazo usirephele yona kahle usondeze kubaba njengabo producer abawu4 abancane. Sisazama ukuyiphusha inkonzo yokuproduce abantu just us uNkulunkulu asisize si interpret inhliziyo and nentando yakhe
kunjalo kunjalo
ngicela ukuyinika
wena. In fact, 1 Peter chapter 2 verse 5 says, you also as living stones are built up a spiritual house to be a holy priesthood, to offer up spiritual sacrifices acceptable to God through Jesus Christ. That is my prayer for you, that you guys may arise and be a spiritual house, a holy priesthood that will offer to God all that is acceptable to him, and offer to God as he enlarges your territory, as he multiplies the anointing, as he enlarges your skill as well, that you may arise and become that spiritual house that will be able to carry forth. Like I use the scripture in Isaiah 43 that talks about where God says, these are the people I've formed for myself, that they may show forth my praise. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, we thank you for this session we've just had right now. Thank you for the people who have tuned in and who were watching. And I want to speak a special blessing upon these beautiful producers, that they are sons to me, that Lord, you may really bless them, that they will know no lack, that no sickness will come by surprise to wipe them off from the face of the earth, that while they are still this side of eternity, you will bless them and you will use them as instruments of honor and instruments of peace. I ask you, my Father, to cover them with the blood of Jesus. I ask you, my Lord, to affirm them and protect them with the name that is above every name. I hide them under your wings, that no seducing spirits may steal them from the perfect will of the Father. I pray that, Lord, you will prosper them, that you will bless their families, you will bless their children, that indeed there will be a gift to the nations. As we know, we are living in the last days. Let them excel with that power and anointing of acceleration. Let them be an instrument. Let them be instruments you can use to deliver and heal those that are oppressed. For we believe there is power in godly music that carries the name of the Lord. We speak this and we call it done. In Jesus' mighty name, amen.
Amen. Thank you, guys. Thank you, guys. We'll see you. We'll see you on Wednesday next week. Please share and post and make sure that everyone gets this. Thank you so much. We'll see you next week, Wednesday. Thank you. We're out. Thank